Hello friends, JT Tapias with the Empty Your Bucket Nutrition Plan channel. And if this is your first time on one of my videos, I enjoy speaking about things that edify the mind, the body, and the spirit from a Christian perspective. Today we're gonna speak about a subject that I know most people struggle with, and that is the subject of weight loss. Most people have tried some kind of fad diet. Maybe you go to the gym 5 or 7 times a week, and yet you don't understand why you haven't been able to get in shape, why you haven't been able to lose the weight, you're still struggling, you've tried keto, Atkins, paleo, South Beach, macro counting, calorie counting, and none of these things have worked with you. And you've gotten to a point where you have just hit that wall called learned helplessness, when you do things over and over and over again, and it just hasn't worked. And so you come to the conclusion that maybe this is not for you, you put your hands up in the air and you say, I am done. If this is you, my friend, I have a solution for you. But before we actually get into the solution, I want to talk to you about the actual challenge, because we need to know what it is we are fighting against, right? We need some clarity so that with that distinction, we can move forward and make some powerful changes that are going to change things radically for you, more importantly, in a very short period of time. So I have 4 points for you here today. I have the challenge, and then I have a solution. Number one, I know that you've struggled in other plans because of complexity. If you've tried to count macros, calories, points, you know exactly what I'm talking about. If you're counting macros, you need to download an app. You need to journal all of your food the night before. Then you need to actually eat the food that you journaled the night before, the day of, because if you sort of derail a little bit, your macros will be off, and then whatever you're calculating will not be accurate, right? And so it throws things off very much. You need to get the labels, you need to weigh food, you need to do a lot of complex things. And the truth is, who has time for that? I don't know about you, but I don't. Calories, points are very similar to that. You have to weigh your food and you have to look at the labels. Very, very, very tedious. More importantly, it is not sustainable long-term. Even elite athletes that try to do this, do it for a season. Maybe they have a competition, maybe they have an event coming up, and they'll count their macros and do all of that stuff. But once they come back to normal life, most of them don't count macros, calories, or points because it's too complex. And then the question is, why would you do it? Number two, I know that most people fear diets because they fear being hungry, right? We think of the first 3 letters of the word diet, we think we're gonna die, right? No one wants to be hungry. Most people that go on these calorie deficits look hangry, right? They look hungry, they look angry, and you see them just miserable, right? It just dims their personality. They're just, they're just trying to get through the day, and you see them doing all of these things to try to sort of avoid the hunger pangs, and they're just miserable altogether. And so hunger is not the best plan for sustainability. Number three, you're at the gym 6-7 days a week, and for a little while that works, it's fun, you're burning some calories, you feel stronger, but you look in the mirror and you're like, man, for the amount of effort that I'm putting in, I just don't see the results. Whether you're at F45 or Orange Theory, or maybe you're at a CrossFit box, right? And you've been working hard, right? You leave and your shirt is drenched. Maybe you have a heart rate monitor and it tells you that you've burned 8 to 1,000 calories. You do that Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday you jump on the scale and you're super optimistic that you're gonna see that scale head in the right direction. All of a sudden, you're at a calorie balance, meaning you didn't lose any weight. You're like, what is going on? I can't sustain all this hard work if it's not gonna pay off, right? And I see people get very, very frustrated. Number four, mindset. I know people have this mindset. They have preconceived notions about what works, what doesn't work. Maybe they've had some experiences. Maybe they've worked with coaches. Maybe they've actually been on a plan where they've actually lost weight. They just weren't able to sustain it. And so their mindset is kind of like, yeah, you know, I always get to a certain point and then I hit the famous word, a plateau. Maybe that's you, maybe you've been there. And so let me answer these one by one. So number one, the complexity, there's no need for diets to be complex. Actually, the Empty Your Bucket Plan, we don't count macros, calories, points, or do any of those things. Even though those things are efficient in the short term, we know in the long term, they just don't work. And so we don't teach those things. Our methodology is a simple way to make proper nutrition a sustainable lifestyle. It can be done. We do it with couch potatoes. Our joke is that we take couch potatoes and we make them into super potatoes in no time. As cheesy as that sounds, it is the truth, my friend. And so complexity can be out the window. You don't need it. I promise you that you can get amazing results without doing any of the point systems or any of the crazy stuff that is just not sustainable long term. Number two, if you are hungry on a diet, you don't need to be. You don't need to deplete calories in a way where you're actually hungry and struggling throughout the day to just you know, get through the day. You don't need that. Most of the people inside of our program, 9 out of 10 people, 12 weeks or 6 months, however long they're with us, report week after week not being hungry. The reason for that is because we can actually change up your nutrients, give you nutrient-dense foods, take out the things that are actually storing glycogen, et cetera. And all we do is replace a solid, nutritious meal or macro for one that wasn't necessarily serving you. And we're taking this one out, but then we're bringing this one in. And so therefore you are not hungry. I'm here to tell you, you don't need to be hungry in order to lose weight and get in tip-top shape. Number three, you don't need to be at the gym 6-7 days a week. Actually, that's one of the hardest ways to get in shape. Most people can't sustain that. I'm a gym goer. I've been a gym goer all of my life. I'm 44 years old. I've probably been going to the gym for 40 years. I think I started when I was 4 years old. And I can tell you that in my 20s and 30s, I used to go 5-6 days a week. But after a while, it just, you get busy. I have kids. I have a family. I have 2 businesses that I run. I don't have time to be there all the time. More importantly, I can't be there for an hour. I need quick workouts that are maybe 25, max 45 minutes, get it in and get out, right? And so I'm here to tell you that you don't need to be at the gym 6-7 days a week. As long as you're getting in 3 days a week and you know what you're doing, that is more than enough, because coupled with the right nutrition, if you're dialing in your nutrition, then it's gonna support your workouts and you don't have to work as hard. The person that you see from afar that looks amazing, that is shredded, is not a person that's at the gym 6-7 days a week. It's a person that is actually paying attention to their nutrition. Lastly, mindset. We have a tendency to drive our car looking through the rear view mirror. If we've had some bad experiences before, if we have some preconceived notions, the tendency is to look through that rear view mirror as we're driving and saying, well, that didn't work for me, or every time I get to XYZ point, I just hit a plateau. My friend, I'm here to tell you that that is called a limiting belief, right? And we need to change the tape. I see people that come from all different plans and diets and working with coaches and being at different gyms, frustrated with a lot of limiting beliefs in a very short period of time, 4 to 6 weeks, we break through those limiting beliefs. People start making amazing progress inside of our program. And the idea is simple, right? We have traveled all of these problems and we have brought solutions to them. More importantly, this video is not meant for you to come on my nutrition program. If you do, great. I'm here to tell you that there is an easy solution to look amazing, to get in tip-top shape. More importantly, to claim your health and show up the way you were meant to show up. My friends, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope I encouraged you. If you loved this video, you're gonna absolutely love this one here. JT Tappas with the Empty Your Bucket Nutrition Plan. I hope you enjoyed it. Talk to you soon. Ciao, ciao.